Hello guys and welcome back to this chaotic gnome forest. I'm Light the Gnome and today we are playing the anecdote of X. I'm so curious about him. I literally don't know anything about X. The only thing that I know about his past is thanks to the character event of Ezra, where they actually interact and X tell to Ezra that in the past he had a really important friend and obviously is dead now, but he had like some sort of plant or something that made him remember his past friend, and Ezra went to the big mountain in search of that little plant just to gift it to him. And this is how they became friends. Also, the other important things that I remember is in the Alienti anecdote is that he and Oliver are enemies to love. No, he and Oliver like to tease each other. Okay, let's put it that way. So, well, okay. So, I really like X as a character already, because I really know him thanks to the other stories and thanks to the main story. The sad thing is actually that in the main story he decided to not be involved anymore with the others when they try to fight the Foundation in the chapter 3, in the chapter 4, sorry. He decided to step back, but in other stories I saw him inside the suitcase, so I guess he's actually going to, like Sonetto, do the exams to be taken inside the Timekeeper squad. So, okay, let's stop chip chat. This is all I know about X. Also, he's an amazing guy and love coffee, so let's go in. I really don't know what this is gonna be. But if it's something that is related to some of the other things that I already know, I would feel glad because I paid attention. Okay, turning forks. Farces always attract undue attention. How about a can of Dr. Pepper? A can of Dr. Pepper. It's like a cola or something. Ooh. The Wheel of Gears. Didn't read that, the title. Thank you for reminding me. The Wheel of Gears. Nice title. Ooh, nice lab. I never saw this one. Inside the suitcase. Is this your room? Inside the suitcase? Okay, right. It's time to do my fantastic and beautiful voice acting thingy. Okay. Fantastic, Regulus. I tried this experiment so many times, but I never had such an amazing result.
Thank you.
You were the perfect fulcrum. I don't know what I would have done without you. Have I really surprised you, then? Ha! You not even seen the best from this captain yet. Check me out! Regulus strikes the ball with her cue. The ball rolls forward, coasting along blindly down an overcomplicated track. After an incomprehensible chain of Father Goldberg reaction, including a toy fire engine and a bowl of spaghetti, what? Sounding off a 21-gun salute in a laboratory, which naturally comes accompanied by a positively wicked rock guitar riff. What? What happened? I guess it's one of those strange domino thingy that X do with his ultimate. Easy pie! Splendid, Captain. This this show of yours, of ours, is ready to stock the world. The two like-minded participants are quick to cheer their success. Wow, this is what they were doing while Vertin and the others were in mission and Regulus went to the Foundation. They were playing together with experiment stuff. Unfortunately, one person, Honey, can be another Vanguard. Oh no. And soon it will not only be fireworks exploding inside the laboratory. Oh! Oopsie. Mesmer, don't be angry. Just what in the hell have you been doing in here? Why is there a toothbrush stuck in the conveying belt? A test tube rack hanging in the air? A banana peel lying on dry ice? And why, just why, are these rhinocerons horn in the disinfection cabinet? Chaotic children play together. Oh my god! I didn't remember you were so high. Mesmer, you're so tiny. Or X, you're so high. Ok. Oh, please, don't mind the mess, Mesmer. All in the name of science. Regulus and I are just testing out some new gadget. A rehearsal for a new performance.
Insanity.
I'm sure I don't need to tell you just how many safety regulations you violated. Not that you would care. And what exactly is the scientific aim you hope to achieve with this absurd contraption? Obviously, it's for the show. Obviously, it's for mechanical science. You might not be familiar with Rube Goldberg machine. Their constituent components may seem obtuse or unusual, but when combined, they produce the result of remarkable precision.
Fabulous.
Oh, indeed, like lighting a firework that you could reach by simply bending down.
All right.
Well, maybe, but it's the process that matters. Otherwise, why would we just die as soon as we born? What a catchphrase.
So gross.
So gross. yes, that's accurate. I think that too. I never seen any viable scientific experiment involved a banana peel on dry ice. For now. What if someday you saw that?
Technically?
Is a science not about exploring the unknown? Into the unknown exists Elsa. As the argument began to spiral up to its peak, Regulus could not help herself from cracking open a bottle of Dr. Pepper.
Insanity.
I have the enough of these childish fancies. Useful mechanics must be concise and repeatable, not this harebrained scheme you cook up in your imagination. That's only your own bias at work, Miss Mesmer. Simple machine might work like that, but it's totally different with complicated system. With all due respect, this invention of yours are nothing more than meaningless garbage. No, don't say that. No. I suggest you dismantle these things immediately and return to the laboratory to its original state.
No, I don't agree.
My work is hardly useless. It reveals the hidden truth of the universe. Have you considered that life itself was born from a subtle Goldberg machine? In the chaotic primordial soup, chemicals collided randomly, forming, by sheer precise coincidence, the foundation of cellular life. Ooh. Similarly, in my apparatus, spheres move repeatedly, eventually reaching a stable outcome, in a transition from chaos to order. So you experiment with the chaos in search of an order? Vertin, Vertin, just in time! I figured they're about to start fight any second! Forget it. I
I thought.
thought the Arcanist here would be normal. Must the timekeeper always be surrounded by this? Did you call for me, Mr. Mesmer? This has been a very bad time to arrive. The atmosphere around Mesmer Jr. at this moment can only be compared to the sky during the Great Fire of London in 1666. Mere second away from Inferno. I was about to say, oh no, 666. That's a bad thing.
Keep away from me.
Never mind, you should know. I will be documenting my observation of this incident in a forthcoming report. Oh no, don't be a snitch. In the character event of Ezra. No! No, I was talking! Well, okay, she went away. Oopsie. Well, I remember that in the character event of Ezra, actually, X Mesmer Junior and Medicine Pocket are all colleagues. They all work in laboratory or some scientific stuff. And but I don't remember they like fight together. They were in a good term, I guess. Maybe not best friend, but still in a good term. So this is a surprise, actually. But it makes sense that Mesmer Junior is not happy with the chaotic way of X to discover things. Potent drugs, what? I was so focused in what I was saying that I didn't notice the title of the second part. Oh, this is scary, okay. An ounce of gold or its equivalent in dollars. X, don't do drugs. That's not the right things to do. In conclusion, Researcher X continues study on mechanical device poses significant safety risk. It is recommended that Researcher X undergo a thorough investigation for compliance, along with all these mechanical devices. No! She really snitch on him. Neat and rotting clear argumentation. It makes for another fine addition to the pile of over 30 other similar complaints. It seems Mermers Jr. has put no small effort into her report. Now someone else has to work overtime to follow them through. No. Relax. There are no safety concerns with any of my devices.
Look.
See, it will all run automatically as soon as you sit down here. And the result is... haha, flower! Thankfully, the subject of our investigation is both cooperative and enthusiastic in demonstrating his work. Next, let me present an experiment that used marbles to turn off a set of light after a 30-minute delay. Oh, and then I'd like to show you my machine that used matches and finished in light to automate watering plants. And then... huh? Leaving so soon? There's still a ton of apparatus and blueprints I haven't shown you yet. A love of science is hard to criticize, but excessive passion in any pursuit can spiral into catastrophe. Are you certain you don't want to review my work again? This is a once in a lifetime opportunity. Oh!
Timekeeper?
Hello! Wow, I love the fact that in this last anecdote we are always inside the suitcase at some point. It made me realize how much the Timekeeper squad is united and how much they interact with each other. They're like all roommates and it's adorable. I love it. Timekeeper, you seem out of breath. Is someone chasing you? Martin was okay, she's so tired of X. Sonetto.
My apologies.
Sorry, Mesmer Jr. said you might be here. I just came to check in. Did I disturb you? In fact, she has arrived just in time. Unfortunately, so does another.
Come on.
Hey, Martin, where were you off to? I thought you and I were supposed to be having fun doing a systematic review of my work. Hello, Mr. X. Oh, hi, Miss Sonetto. I suppose you being here must mean we have a new mission?
That's right.
Precisely. The Foundation is to relocate an arcanist to headquarters before the storm. The risk for this operation is relatively low. Timekeeper, you've been given free rein to designate your team member for this task. Ooh! So we're going to be part of a squad. Let me guess, are we going to have X and Mesmer Jr. together? Because Vertin want them to understand each other more.
It doesn't seem that this mission target is rather tricky. Madame Z suggests that you bring along a team member who excels at communication.
Hey, why are you looking at me like that? Because you're gonna be one of them. Oh, into the car! Who is driving? I can't believe you dragged me out here.
I'd love to help, but you know, field mission aren't my strong suit. I'm more of a laboratory rat, you know? You won't be back to the laboratory before the investigation ends. Is that your his punishment? Yes, yes, yes. I will do whatever I can to assist. But aren't most arcanists known for their difficult personalities? What's so special about this guy? Sonetto flips through the mission book. Our target is Vlad Wilson, born into a family of potion makers. He's currently the sole owner of Wilson Pharmaceutical. It also says he seems to be tied up in some kind of medical dispute. You're originally American, aren't you, Mr. X? Are you familiar with the name?
I regret to inform you.
I grew up in the slums, Sonetto. Not really the kind of place you just bump into pharmaceutical moguls. Really, I don't see how I can help with this mission. Maybe you should consider grabbing someone else. I can ask Ed Beck. In all this time, I still don't know why he had this black eye. I mean, I don't know if it's natural somehow or artificial. If some of you know, I would love to know about it, because I'm still interrogating, and I still don't know the answer. Okay. Oh no, double response, wait. Okay. We could let you out here if you'd like. My response when someone is messing inside my car while I'm driving. I caution you to remember the subject of your laboratory privilege. Now I'm gonna do the driver response.
Sorry.
No, I didn't mean in that way. Please don't kick me out in the middle of nowhere. Oh, sorry, that was
good.
Mean. So back to the case. How did he get into this medical dispute? As far as lawsuits go, I've heard that these type of cases are notoriously thought. Got any more information in that book of yours? The details of the dispute were not included in the mission book, nor did Madame Z say anything. Perhaps it is personal matter for Mr. Wilson. It is immaterial to our mission. We only need to coordinate with him about the transfer. Yes, I just hope things go smoothly. Brum! The car comes to a sudden stop, still a long distance to go to the target location. What is it? An ambush?
What a coincidence.
No, it seems to be a protest. Someone bangs on the car window frantically. Boycott Wilson Pharmaceuticals! Stop the patent acquisition! Give us back our medication! Oh no. Wilson Pharmaceutical is a price-gouging monster! Through they move to roll up the windows, streams of flyer are pushed in before it closes up entirely.
Right.
Oh, you were right, Miss Sonetto. This whole medication dispute doesn't seem to have anything to do with our mission or Arcanum in general.
Got it.
But I think I figured out what makes this Wilson guy so tricky. Take a look at yourself. Sonetto takes the flyer. Vlad Wilson recently listed 49 drugs passion for sale. What? One of which is the only treatment for a copper metabolism disorder. And if the proposed sales go through, the price will be increased from $1 per capsule to $550. Wow, that's shocking for sure. I mean, there's some price gap there. The Matthew effect. Can I spoiler myself searching on Google? No, I think they're going to explain to me. To those who have, more will be given. Okay. Well, what are you worried about? We own the patent, so that we charge for it is our right. Doesn't matter whatever it's sold for $1 or
I don't remember. I can only count to 100. I'm very sorry. No, I don't know. It's none of their darn business. Let the whiners whine all they like. The law is on our side. Well, I'm not going to delay this signing any longer. If you don't want to set these things to my price, then I can always sell the patent to Briggs instead. You get me? Uh-huh. I guess. Wilson Company Office. He slammed the phone down. Sonetto, waiting patiently, Alast seized the opportunity to speak. Mr. Wilson, we are investigating from the San Pavolin Foundation. As per the contract, please return to headquarters with us.
Of course.
Yeah, of course, I fully intend on complying with the foundation. But first I need to take care of some company business, as you can see. I'm in a little pickle, and things are far from settled here. You'll just have to wait a few days more until this contract is finalized. Don't worry about it, you and your little investigators can put your feet up and relax. We'll be fully covering your travel expenses while you wait. Oh. But this isn't what we originally agreed to, Mr. Wilson. Okay.
That's right,
Mr. Wilson. More importantly, the storm does not wait. Think I don't know that? That's why I've got to hurry up and sell these patents. Anyway, it's not like you've got any choice in the matter, or didn't you read the rider? Wilson smiled sharply. Ix cast a confused glance at Sonetto. There is indeed a clause. 17.2.2. The foundation is required to assist in the transfer of property from Wilson Pharmaceuticals. We will fulfill our obligation. But Mr. Wilson, if the storm comes, it will be too late.
Please.
Relax, little Miss Foundation, it won't take long. I mean, if in the storm everything is destroyed and fucked up, why is he trying to solve the matters before going away? If he actually goes away right now and the storm happens, I mean, he will be safe and nothing is like nothing actually happened. I'm still confused how the storm actually works. If it actually reset everything, or is like a temporary anomaly that just affects Arcanist and other people. Well, after my acquisition is complete, I'll honor the contract. I got my reason for this, you'll see. Till the end, I got work to do. Now get out of here. Go make yourself comfortable. Okay. I don't like this guy. The protesters are still marching outside the office building. Cancel this sale! Protect patients' right! It's so funny seeing them inside the car. Ix roll up the window.
Looks like
this Wilson guy is pretty smart. I can't believe he got us to send that rider with the foundation. Do we just keep waiting like this?
Timekeeper,
I do understand your concern. But according to the term of the rider, all we can do now is wait.
But
Mr. Wilson didn't even give us a definitive timeline. What are we going to do? Just wait around until the very last moment before the storm?
No.
That won't be necessary. If need be, I'll ask headquarters for permission to transfer him forcibly. I'm not sure if that will do much to help. Seem like headquarters were full aware of Wilson's little pickle, but they still choose to make disagreement with him. I see. So that's how it is.
Looks like
Miss Sonetto, I think we misunderstood the true purpose of our mission. What do you mean? Sure, Wilson is an arcanist, but he's a businessman first. He is just trying to seek the best outcome for his interest.
So?
So, after learning about the storm, he chose to join up with the Foundation, but he also chose to tell off his patients that he is aiming on getting the most he can. Of course, he had to expect that this would cause a lot of trouble, but as long as he's the rightful patient owner, he can sell it to anyone and for any price. Then he prepared his own retreat. Wow, what a fisherman. So we here as a security? Mm-hmm, you got it, Miss Vertin. He knew the Foundation would send someone to pick him up. He also knew he could make the stick around using the rider.
This is not good.
So if the situation deteriorates any further, he'll be able to use us as his shield. Mr. X, what do you mean? Think about it. Might he not, for example, make us suppress a riot if it becomes a threat?
No.
Ridiculous. We will, of course, ensure Mr. Wilson's personal safety, but we are under no obligation to follow his order.
Got it.
Miss Sonetto, I can see why Madame Z warned you about this mission. The moment you said, of course, you fell into his trap.
Huh?
I don't understand. Like it or not, intend to make this part of our mission.
That's right.
Yes, just follow the chains of event. All he will need to do is demonstrate that it is our job to assist in the transfer of property and protect the mission target, and on principle we cannot refuse him. But the contracts say nothing about suppressing riots.
So?
So then the next part is clear. We got to find a break in the chain, exploit it before he passes that back onto us. Huh?
Why are you
looking at me like that?
This is...
Sorry, your analysis was so reasonable that I almost lost my train of thought. Seems like we must entrust this next part to you, X. Wait, are we starting to pass the buck already? You had the idea? You gonna work for the idea?
This is not good.
Well, I can probably keep him safe, but I'm not sure if I'm the right person for the job. Of course you are, Mr. X, and I must say it is truly an honor to be in this mission with you. Oh, Sonetto, you're so cute. Your insight has been most invaluable to our mission, truly. Well, this mission just went from bad to worse.
Gotta go.
I'd better get out of here because before you two find more work to give me. That was such a Oliver-coded phrase. Look at this little smile with his cheek is adorable. This smile is adorable. You're adorable. See you later, my heartless friends. I mean, that's fair. That's valid. They are heartless. This chapter are shorter. So maybe we're not going to go more than an hour of video. I would be glad, actually, if this could be an hour long video and not more. The kids. Beyond curiosity and imagination lies a little bit of vindictiveness. Okay. There's never much fun in waiting around, but I'll say one thing for her. She never wastes time.
Morning, timekeeper. Did you happen to see Mr. X?
Weren't you two just together?
Yes, but after we left Mr. Wilson's office, X suddenly claimed he had to get some coffee. But when I went to check, he wasn't in the cafe downstairs. I was hoping to ask him to go over the rider again and perhaps draw up a formal proposal.
Could you use my help instead?
Oh, no. Please, timekeeper, leave the paperwork to your capable assistant. But if you do have time, could I trouble you to help me find Mr. X?
Indeed, where did he go? Where are you?
Underground parking lot.
Finding X is not hard. One only need to consider where someone would go when they're trying to dodge work. So we're spacious, quiet, and off the beat track.
Alright.
Okay, one more wire to go. Who wants to provide our final lucky wire? Me! The children? X finds himself in an old garage, when he has set up in near to the protester, and in front of him now stands a rudimentary Rube Goldberg machine. So far it consists of marbles, wires, rusty horns, and sprinkle, and a bucket with the bottom missing, household junk. Before him, a group of kids from the protest gather around, looking at the contraption in amazement.
Thank you.
Thanks to everyone's enthusiasm and support, our fully automatic marble launcher is finally ready. Simply adjust the machine to the desired angle and press this spring. Then we can enjoy a marvelous flying marble show. Who wants to go first? The children eagerly raise their hands. One little girl is particularly loud in her excitement. Ladies first. Let's let Sophia, our prized backer sponsor, come up and take our maiden flight. Haha, I told you to get you back for spring me with that sprinkle. Sophie lets out a vindictive load as she turns the machine towards her companions and presses the spring down smugly. The marble bursts up and outward, rolling around inside the bottomless bucket 3 times, and then flying out high, traveling through the rusty horn before it lands right back where it started. Ue.
Done.
Beautiful, an admirated success, Sophie.
Technically?
You see, no matter what angle you set it at, the marble will always return to its original position.
This is a discovery.
A truly epic invention, a fully automated marble launcher with itself reset for a limited use. Okay, maybe not so enthusiastic for children, but it look cool. X begins to clap for himself. The response is an overwhelming chorus of boos from the kids. Hey, what's this all about, mister? You promised me that marble will fly 30 feet. In fact, I promised that the vertical flight distance would be 30 meters. And what about the precise targeting? It didn't even hit them. A marble falling back into its exact starting point is the very definition of precise targeting. If I know it was just gonna do that, I never would have given you the bucket. The kids start into an uproar as loud as the protests outside. Ugh, kids. Mixed in are shouts of a make better one. Give me back my sprinkle and I'm telling my mom that you're a weirdo. The atmosphere is electric, to say at the least.
What?
Is Mr. X putting on some kind of performance for these children? He seems to be enjoying it. Oh, Vertin, Missonetto, when did you get here? Don't be so nervous, Mr. X. The timekeeper just wants to see your latest performance. Right, so what is this sprinkle she just mentioned? It's the most fun machine in the whole world. It made Sophie cry and call for her mama. I wasn't crying. That was just water. Looks like there was quite a showdown here. Don't look at me like that. I solemnly swear that this machine was carefully designed to avoid any risk of harm. I can explain this. As X begins to speak, several calling voices are heard in the distance. Ah, that's my mom. Guess it's time for my medicine. Again. Oh no. What medicine? Yeah, my dad say we got to leave soon. So wanna meet up and play here tomorrow? I don't know. Mom say she might have to take me back to the hospital, but only if Mr. Wilson grow a heart. That sucks. Why do we gonna be sick? It'd be cool if we just wind up a spring and reset like this weirdo story. Oh. So you say you didn't like my automatic marble launcher? Yeah, cause I don't. I'm going home. You can keep the broken bucket, Mr. Weirdo. The children begin to leave, heading back towards their waiting parents.
So, is that...
Who were these kids? They're all children with congenital copper metabolism disorder. I'll explain, but just wait a sec. X let out a sigh and begin to dismantle his contraption, carefully removing each of the different donated pieces. It'll be just a minute. Children with disease, no. I don't like it. Starting point, end point. It's a law of physics. There are no exception. Point A and point B. Point A and point B, sorry. So then their parents are the protesters we encountered at the march.
That's right.
Yes, so their parents have been protesting outside Wilson Pharmaceutical for days now, so I offered to watch their kids. I wanted to give these kids a bit of a break, make something fun for them, you know? A lot of them have been in and out of hospital for a long time, so I thought they could use something to lift their spirit. Oh, X, you're so cute. Hopefully, they'll never have to know why their parents were protesting. So you decide to make a toy for them? Oh, it wasn't just a toy.
Technically,
I prefer to describe it as a project. It seems you're very passionate about this project.
This is a very, very inspiring creation.
Aww, this voice line is adorable. Look at her. You're adorable. Mr. X, it was very kind of you to create such an amusement for these children. But there's another angle to it. You've got them involved. A sense of involvement is important for attracting an audience. But your investor protested the production didn't meet the expectation.
Sorry.
Well, I can't help that. I can't just let the little kids run around with a marble launcher that just shoot off anywhere now, can I?
And I?
Still, seems like I'm not so good at building a respectable rapport with these kids. You sell yourself short, Mr. X. It's plainly clear they like you. Well, I appreciate your confidence. The way they play reminds me a lot of the other kids who played in the orphanage growing up. Oh, that's right. The other friends he was talking about in the Ezra character event was from orphanage, because he also is from an orphanage. I remember this much.
Huh?
Orphanage?
That's right.
Yes, it's a bit different from growing up in the San Pavolian Foundation like you did. Back then, I had a lot of siblings. I would often make machines like this. I'd get them to invest too.
What?
But later...
Hmm.
Oh no, did something happen? I joined the foundation and, well, frankly, it's hard to find the same sort of investors there. Oh, is that so?
That's right.
Of course, my brother and sister back then would give me anything I needed, just to see what I'd make. But when it comes to convincing adults like Laplace and Mesmer, they're not so eager, especially that overbearing complainer.
What?
What was that about Miss Mesmer? Oh, nothing, nothing. She's a fine colleague. I mean, you were just... You can talk bad about a person that is doing something you don't like. I mean, you're not... You don't hate her and you're not I desire that something really bad happened to her. I mean, if you need to complain about something, about someone, I think you can do that. I know it's bad to talk in the back of other people, but still, sometimes you need it. And just before do the confrontation, when I'm angry at someone, I need to talk to someone else before. And then when I clear my mind, then I can actually confront the other person. So I don't think talking in the back is a bad thing. So if you program to actually talk to the person, then so you can talk, X.
You can talk bad about Mesmer, we don't care, we're going to maintain the secret. But then you need to do the confrontation with her. When your mind is clear and you're not angry anymore.
No.
Oh, perhaps I heard you wrong. You're wrong. But what Sophie just said does remind me of something Miss Mesmer Jr. said about mankind. One only need to press the button to activate the feature, the toggle switch connect the circuits. If only the human condition could be repaired like a machine.
Interesting.
Miss Sonetto, do you realize that an excellent proposition on mechanical theory?
Huh?
What do you mean? I'm afraid I don't know anything at all about mechanical theory. No, no.
What a coincidence.
What you just quoted, or should I say proposed, is precisely what lies at the heart of the LSCC ethos. If we know the state of the universe at some initial time, you can determine its state in any other time. The ultimate goal of the LSCC is to build an omniscient, intelligent machine capable of doing just that.
This is...
Is
fantastic.
That so? That would be an amazing feat. That would be scary.
But...
But I'm afraid this would still not achieve Miss Mesmer ideal.
I regret to inform you.
Miss Sonetto, if society were to behave like a perfect machine and each element would follow a precise and predictable orbit, what will determine who benefits from the system and who doesn't?
I'm not sure.
The system? The initial point? Because in a measured orbit, everything is predetermined. So we only need to calculate the initial position of any other part to calculate all its state from past to future in the orbit. Therefore, if the ball is set to move from point A to point B, then it might be that wealth is destined to flow from the poor to the rich. And because the system is so designed that only those who pay get treatment, so an individual with higher starting point will receive the greater benefit. Oh! Ooh, this is actually a very interesting argument. It's a rational system and a legal one for now. No surprise and no miracles. Seems to be confusing social system for mechanic ones. Ooh.
All right.
Fundamentally, there is no difference between human and machines. Oh, I apologize. I've gone off topic. Miss Sonetto, would you mind help me clean this up?
Okay.
Happy to help. But what did you mean by the initial point? No, she's so curious. Oh, maybe Sonetto is the childlike that X need, because he don't have any more children that are enthusiastic about his work, his knowledge and his project. But Sonetto is a little childlike. I mean, she's a curious girl. So I think it's adorable. The way they're interacting with each other. Gravitational potential. Oh no, physic. EP. MGH. This law also applies to social construct. Okay. I'm gonna believe you, I guess. Mr. Wilson Patton's transfer has been delayed now for 3 days. Today is the last day to sign. According to the agreement, we will transfer Mr. Wilson to headquarters immediately after the contract is signed. But now... Price Gordon Kill! Give us back our money! Back! Get back! A regime protest surrounds the Wilson Pharmaceutical Building, waiting for his cart to depart. Once the contract is signed, the only effective drug for a serious copper metabolism disorder will rise from $1 to $550. For both sides, this seems to be their last chance.
Hello.
Hello, are you from the Sound Powell Foundation? We're with Mr. Wilson. We'd like to ask you to accompany us to the signing location to keep things under control.
I'm sure you don't understand that it is not our responsibility. According to the river you signed with Mr. Wilson, the foundation must assist Wilson Pharmaceutical in the transfer of all property. These patents are the company property. Please understand that we are only asking you to act in accordance with the contract. I understand. We will do what we must assist you. Sonetto. Just you, miss? Nowhere is the contract doesn't specify the number of people that must be present during this transfer. The timekeeper has more important tasks, so this obligation will be fulfilled by me and her assistant.
Of course,
I'm certain we can trust in your capabilities as an agent of the San Pablo's Foundation. Please follow me.
No worries.
Not to worry, timekeeper. I'll decide wherever it is necessary to activate our emergency plan to protect Mr. Wilson as the situation develops. You and Mr. X should take this time to make preparation for the transfer. Sonetto and the clerks from Wilson Pharmaceutical takes their leave. Everything is proceeding just as X said it would, yet the Prophet himself is not present. Instead, on the roof of an abandoned high-rise building, a lone figure stands against the wind. The splash art, yes. You're so baby. If there is an intelligence that can understand all the forces that bring vitality to nature, and all the elements and things that constitute nature and their current state, and this intelligence is great enough to analyze all this data, then from the largest object in the universe to the smallest particle, the movement of every body in time and space can be encompassed in the same formula. For this intelligence, nothing is uncertain. The future will unwind before it with the same certainty that the past does. The wind rustles the page of the book.
Interesting.
What a beautiful discourse, Mr. Laplace.
What?
It's just a pity. The butterfly has already flapped its wing. When you were erecting that performance machine, did you ever think that even the smallest gears might have a will of their own? Ooh. Ooh. What a nice speech. The protesters are gathering in front of Wilson Pharmaceuticals. The rage of the crowd is growing to a fever pitch. Down with Wilson! Wilson has blood in his hand! Darn it, we won't be able to get out. Allow me. Sonetto takes a deep breath.
May the peace be with us.
Then she lifts her arm high. Vi appellar. A simple and harmless arcane skill. He grants a blessing to the road so that Wilson Carey is able to safely drive away despite the crowds. The headlights come on. Everyone can only watch as Wilson car speed away, harmlessly passing through the crowd. Useless whiness, what does this idiot know? It costs money to go to London, to develop a drug, to avoid the storm, to come back. Everything costs money. Besides, why should I care about things like ethic when the storm is about to wash away everything? I don't have time for this. Get out of the way, you stupid bastard. Wilson pushes his driver out, taking the wheels of his car and slamming onto gas pedal. Oh? Sonetto! What happened? The smoke disperses. The crowd has instantly retreated from the crash, forming a large circle. Smoke billows out from Wilson's black car. It has crumpled up like a crushed soda can. A sudden and unexpected accident. Oh my god! Wilson is dead! He was crushed by his own company saying falling down! Oh... Was it X? Was it X doing? Seemed like God finally took an interest, alleluia!
Caspita!
How could this have happened? I have a theory. Perhaps it is only a momentary illusion, but it seems to Vertin that she has spied the fluctuation of an arcane skill not far away from an abandoned Igrise. Yet a second look confirmed there is no one to be seen. Ooh, Ix, ooh. Ooh. I mean... I mean, they said they need to go back with Wilson in the Foundation, but they didn't say he needed to be totally healthy. Isn't that right, Ix? oopsie. Silent machine. Everything in its place.
My apologies.
I'm terribly sorry, Timekeeper. We failed our mission. I should have done something sooner. This wasn't your fault, Sonetto. I'm afraid it was completely unavoidable. Well, the second one. No, no need to comfort me, Timekeeper. I'm prepared to take full responsibility. Sonetto! Yes. Well, I'm going in. Sonetto disappeared through the door to the interrogation room. No, I don't know if Ix is gonna confess for help, just for helping Sonetto, or if he's gonna stay silent. Ah, I should have expected we'd fall into some trouble when we return to the Foundation. Seems like I'm not cut out of for field mission. I mean, if you hurt the target, and if not a hurting target mission. Is that really the story you're going with?
This is not good.
What? We haven't even entered the interrogation room, and you're already starting to question me? This face. Don't change the subject, Mr. Ix.
All right.
Fine, but before you begin, let me ask first. What makes you think I did anything? Your absence at the scene was noted, convenient even. I was just playing games with the kids. You read the report. I'm sure you'll find that they all passed the lie detector test that was administered, verifying my whereabouts at the time. Sound of gear was heard at the crime scene.
It's a normal symptom.
And I'm sure you also read that the report concluded that there was a loose part on the sign. As for the gears, come on, it's New York, that could have been anything. It's easy to fake an accident with Goldberg machine. All of life is a Rube Goldberg machine. The only question is the outcome and the initial point.
What?
But you're asking, did I make it? If I did, where was it, Falchrom? There wasn't any trace of a machine at the scene. Oh well. Robbing into race. Ultimately, X is a common feature of every Goldberg apparatus. From a Regulus firework lighting cue, to Sophie marble launching spring. Human action is the initial point for every mechanical device. The participants themselves are a part of the experiment. Their behavior, their action, engineered as a part of the machine. Stable, controllable, and able to follow the instruction. We have the flashback. Your fulcrum was a person. You used a sonetto? No way!
Sorry.
I don't know what you could possibly mean. We both know I wasn't there, so who could I have controlled Miss Sonetto action? Are you trying to say that Miss Sonetto acted as my accomplice? That's a very serious accusation, wouldn't you say? You... Vertin? They're calling you Vertin. Maybe we can talk more after this. No way. Oh no! The interrogation room
so,
is the
is the punishment room. So, do you have any additional information to add about the incident? Anything that could help will be big welcome, Timekeeper. Please answer honestly. Silence. At first, the choice to speak up would have only implicated one person, but that is no longer the case. I have shared all the information I know.
Nice.
I understand. Thank you for your cooperation. Ah. Ah. You're not gonna snitch for X? Ah. They wait for the verdict drags on a sword hanging over the head of two friends, deadly on a threat. Finally.
Timekeeper!
Timekeeper, great. I've been looking for you. I'm to inform you that the Foundation has dismissed their investigation.
Dismissed?
The result from the crime scene found no trace of unexpected arcane activity. The case has been officially ruled an accident. Still, I'm planning on staying late at the Foundation, so I can volunteer for the very next mission. I must rectify this blot out on our records. Wait, but is Wilson dead? The man is actually dead, or is just very injured?
Are you leaving?
Yes, I have something to take care of. Named X.
Alright.
Oh, alright. Well, see you soon. By the way, it seems like the passion acquisition was determined after Mr. Wilson's accident. So it seems the price of the drug will remain $1. Oh, well. Could this truly have been God's will? I don't think so. Or perhaps it was there a devil in the machine. Ooh. You look angry. Did you see this coming? You're overestimating my skill, Miss Vertin. Arcanists are good with intuitive insight, and humans are good with logic-based deduction. When the two compete against each other, they might turn a blind eye to the absurdity and chaos that is the world and what happened to certain people in it. Vertin,
sorry.
I'm sorry about the accident.
What?
But the rain falls on the just and the unjust alike. Isn't that what they say? Arcanists and humans, the poor and the rich. As long as we all work this art, we're all the same. That's just how the world works. So are we all just cogs in the machine to you? When the marble is set, it doesn't really matter what triggers the spring. It flies and its targets will always be the same. In fact, when you consider the mechanic nature of reality, we all cogs of one kind of another. You used your friend, my friend. You used her. That's why you're upset. Well, I understand. Don't worry. I promise you won't see any more device that pose safety risk in the laboratory after this. X turned to leave, but stop again. Oh, now that their investigation is over, would you mind if I took some of this letter off your hands? The mechanical expert smiles, waving the document back at her before disappearing through the laboratory doorway. In conclusion, researcher X's study on mechanical device poses significant safety risk, which through unintended consequence might result in damage, including but not limited to burns, collision, disabilities, death, etc. X takes a sip of his coffee, marveling with pride at the word as he raised the letter into the air. A marvelous insight. These machines certainly have their dangers. Burning. There certainly it is a risk. X tapped the edge of his cap, beginning a series of outrageous mechanical movement, as Mesmer tack of complaints is pulled. Oh no! Let me read! Is pulled one by one from his desk and funneled into the fireplace, where they turn to ash, leaving not a single trace. Ooh. The end!
Wow! This is shocking. This is actually the first time we go for an anecdote and it's not actually very positive. Or very sad for some reason. I mean, Ixa is such a great character. Oh, this is unexpected. I mean, not totally, because I mean, just the fact that he decided in the chapter 4 to step back and not fight with all the situation that was going in the Foundation and Verti and so on, I already sensed that he wasn't a really totally good guy, but at the same time I wasn't expecting him to be a great character. So this anecdote actually filled something. I mean, it told me something more about this character, not about his past, that I already know a little, thanks to the Ezra character event, but at the same time, I didn't expect this at all. And, I mean, he used Sonetto, that was so curious about his work, what he was studying, what he was saying, and she's super innocent. He used her for committing a crime to do something bad against a bad person, but still Sonetto doesn't know that it's actually her incantation that did this, but it's not her fault, it's because of X. And yes, he was just actually trying to help all the Protestants, all the people, and all the kids that were in need. But he used the power of his friend for this, without letting no one know. This is something. I mean, I actually really like this outcome. I'm not happy for Sonetto, obviously. I hope she'll never discover the truth, because I know she would feel really bad for more than one reason, and she have the right to feel super bad and actually eventually angry with X. The timekeeper was also angry. Vertim was also already angry with him for the same reason, and I hold the right. She said, "You used your friend," and then she also said "my friend." So it was like a statement. It was like she said, "You're not a real friend to her because you used her for this." And she don't know that. And yes, that was a really bad thing. I can't justify him. That was a really bad thing from him. He did a really bad thing using Sonetto. But he did that for his own justice. For helping all the people. Going against the Foundation will without let them discover him. Because they couldn't discover him if it was Sonetto doing. This is... Am I PNG blocked? Because I was too focused on talking. I still don't understand what is the deal with this PNG. One day I'll discover it. Okay. Actually, I should have some of your story unlocked. Nice, everything is unlocked, so we can read a lot this time. After the Second Industrial Revolution, countless factories were set up. The roar of machinery continued around the clock as the wave of modernization affected every aspect of the American society. Radio, automobiles, steam power ships, and airplanes changed the way people lived. The great machine age had arrived. Cutting-edge machines could help people solve issues from dining to traveling. Though they might be complex, sophisticated, and expensive. Rube Goldberg machine were thus born. They are convoluted yet incredibly simple. In comparison with the mass-produced mechanical components in factory, Goldberg's machine use parts that are much simpler and more absurd. Their invention might be meant to poke fun at the head of precise engineer. Though nobody actually know the truth, some think it's a joke, but there are others who are very serious about it. Waterland and Higher Autonomy Blimps, a sensational work by young engineer genius. He clutches at the newspaper in his hand and made the face at the picture of a teenager loathing in a giant blimp. He then smugly placed the newspaper in the most conspicuous spot of the cabinet, next to some oddly shaped machine. Then the next day, he took the latest newspaper, where they found an every more high-catching headline, a foolish genius, no plans of selling the blimp's design, next a breadcrumbs spraying dispenser. He spotted and muttered, soundly slightly put out, "They're so harsh, I'm no more than an average Joe." Another newspaper was carefully placed in the cabinet. Pandora Wilson? I have a lapsus right now. I remember this name is important, but I don't remember who it is. I knew that something like this will happen. It always like this. Or I totally forgot the name, or I remember the name, but I totally forgot about the person. Please introduce this exquisite mechanical ball you're holding. It's just a toy I made for fun instead. I like to introduce this auto-seduction lipstick I've just invented. Have a look. Is there anyone in the world better suited to test this out? That's all right. What an impressive invention. Let's talk about something else. There was an incident at an orphanage a few years ago, and I heard you were present. Oh? If you want to discuss topics that have nothing to do with the interview, you have to test this bubblegum spraying alarm clock in exchange, okay? The deceased appeared to have been killed by a loose shingle from the roof. The angle, wind, speed, and power it had was an incredibly precise. Oh, such is life. It's filled with coincidence and accident. Don't be sad. Now let's try this mini priest bouncer and pray for him, shall we? Please excuse me. Ouch, don't pull me. No way! Did he actually... Did he actually did that also to his orphanage? X, I'm shocked! Okay, so you're telling me that X was all along a chaotic grey character. There is only focused. I mean, he's only focused on his experiment. And he totally ignores all the thing they said about his work being dangerous. In the end, he burned away the papers of Mesmer complaining about his work. You know, this is actually totally unexpected. I didn't expect him to be such a grey character. He's not, I don't feel like he's evil, but he is not doing so many good things on his own. So this is really something. I'm so surprised. Okay, for the first time, this is not an anecdote where I can just say, oh yes, it was so good, it was so well written, I like it a lot, blah blah blah. But it's actually one that made me genuinely shocked, because I didn't know X was such a character, such a wow. This is something indeed. I don't think my my way of seeing the character change. I still like Ix. Now even more, because I'm more curious about him as a character. He's more complex than I thought it would actually be. So I'm curious to know if actually someone, after playing or seeing this anecdote, see Ix in a bad light now, because I'm actually seeing him in a bad light, but at the same time I'm more curious of what I'm seeing. Instead of repulsion, I fear attraction, okay? So let me know in the comment, what do you think about this anecdote, about this outcoming, if you already knew that Ix was a great character, or if you discovered it with me with this anecdote. And well, I guess this is all. Thank you all for being here with me, and we'll see each other in the next video, on the next part. Bye bye, guys.